Welcome to JSC Online Class. My dear students, how are you all? Hope all of you are fine. I am also fine. This is my fourth class with HSC students. So ICT class for HSC students, class number 4, chapter 4, chapter name, Introduction to Web Design and HTML. In this online class, we will try to learn about HTML code, HTML tags, HTML elements, and HTML attributes. Today we will learn everything. My dear students, stay home and enjoy our online classes.
HSC ICT, class number 4, chapter 4, chapter name, Introduction to Web Design and HTML. HTML. At first, we will know what is HTML. HTML means Hypertext Markup Language. It is the standard markup language for documents designed to be displayed in a web browser. It can be assisted by technologies such as cascading style sheets, that means CSS, and scripting language such as JavaScript. How does HTML work? HTML documents are files that end with a .html or .htm extension. You can view them using any browser such as Google Chrome, Safari, or Mozilla Firefox. The browser reads the HTML file and renders its content so that internet users can view it. We can write the HTML code that are displayed in this picture. After writing the HTML code, save the HTML document. That's why we have to select a name and save the document with the extension .html or .htm. After that, we have to select the desired location where we want to save the HTML file. Here the file name is index and extension is .html. Now, advantages and disadvantages of HTML. Advantages. HTML is widely used. Every browser supports HTML language, easy to learn and use. Do not need to purchase any extra software because it is by default in every Windows. Disadvantages. HTML can create only static and plain pages. So, if we need dynamic pages, then HTML is not useful. Need to write a lot of code for making a simple web page. Security features are not good at HTML. If we need to write long code for making a web page, then it produces some complexity. Now HTML tags. HTML tags are element names surrounded by angle brackets. These are the angle brackets, and if you want to write a tag, you have to write the tag name inside the angle bracket. This one is tag name, this is opening tag, and this is closing tag, and this portion is the tag element. HTML tags normally come in pairs like opening tag and closing tag. Here is an example of a tag paragraph. This one is opening tag and this one is closing tag. The first tag in a pair is the start tag or opening tag. The second tag is the end tag or closing tag. The end tag is written like the start tag but with the forward slash inserted before the tag name. Here is an example of a paragraph tag. This is opening tag and this is closing tag. And to write a closing tag, at first you have to write the opening tag, and before the tag name you have to use a forward slash. HTML elements. An HTML element usually consists of a start tag and an end tag with the content inserted in between. The HTML content is everything from the start tag or the end tag. Here is an example of an HTML element. Here we use a H1 tag, that means the largest heading tag. Look at the picture. This one is head tag, and inside the head tag there is title tag. So this one is head element and this one is body tag, the opening body tag and closing body tag, and this portion is body element. And total the HTML file, that means this one is HTML opening tag and this one is HTML closing tag, that means the total HTML element is here. Now nested HTML element. HTML elements can be nested. Elements can contain elements. All HTML documents consist of nested HTML elements. A nested element, also called a child element, can be a parent element too if other elements are nested within it. HTML tags should be nested in correct order. They must be closed in the inverse order of how they are defined. That means the last tag opened must be closed first. Here is an example of nested elements. HTML attributes. Attributes define additional characteristics or properties of the element, such as width and height of an image. Attributes are always specified in the start tag or opening tag, and usually consists of name value pairs like name equals to value. Attribute values should always be enclosed in quotation marks. This is an example of an attribute. Here anchor tag is used. This one is opening tag and this one is closing tag. Here the attribute name is href, that means hyper reference, and the attribute value is contact.html. This is the name of a page. Thank you.